Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to thank UNESCO and the governments of the United Kingdom, Ghana, and Norway for convening this very important meeting at a critical juncture for the future of humanity and the education of our children. The call to reimagine and to recommit to education is opportune at a time when the COVID-19 global pandemic is leaving millions without jobs. I have always held the deep conviction that education is the greatest equalizer. In that vein, the Namibian government, in line with the Sustainable Development Goal number 4, attaches great importance on access to education. Our education system, which is based on access, equity, and equality, receives more than 20% of the national budget. We have succeeded in expanding access and equity in the education sector. Unfortunately, COVID-19 threatens to reverse the gains we have made in pursuance of the goal of quality education for all. Therefore, during this period of COVID-19, where we have to ensure that no child is left behind, additional resources have been allocated to infrastructure improvement, water, sanitation, learner accommodation. Under COVID-19, we had to ensure that the reopening of schools occurs under conditions that are consistent with our commitment to health as biggest priority. The safe return of learners to school was guided by COVID-19 best practices in accordance with the WHO protocols. We are proud to state that children have returned to school and their situation is closely monitored through the decentralized structures of government. On the issue of an inclusion, equity, and gender equality, a strong policy framework for inclusion in education sectors ensures that the Ministry of Education is responsive to the needs of children with disabilities, orphans, and those with vulnerabilities. To guarantee that children with disabilities, orphans, and vulnerable communities do not fall victims to abuse, including sexual and gender-based violence, the National Safe Schools framework is currently being reinforced. Your Excellencies, without doubt, COVID-19 exposed a digital divide among students, families, and geographical locations. The pandemic is challenging governments to think anew about teaching and learning. In order to harness equitable connectivity in technologies for learning, the government in a public-private smart partnership with communities is now investing in ECD education by A, ensuring that all education facilities are well equipped with ICT infrastructure, and B, ensuring that all educators are capacitated when it comes to ICT usage. We have learned that online information services open up real possibilities of keeping parents much more engaged with what their children are doing. And parents are able to have a dialogue of the school on how they are progressing. Indeed, the post-COVID-19 environment is showing the way that technology is the key to personalized learning, and we have accelerated our interventions in that regard. Yes, COVID-19 is a challenge, but it has also opened up the opportunity for leveraging hybrid models that include technology and physical presence for better learning outcomes. To conclude, I wish to assure Your Excellencies that the Namibian government stands ready to support better coordination and strengthening of mechanisms to accelerate the implementation of SDG 4 in the context of COVID-19 and beyond. And I thank you.